السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you, brother and sister? Hoping إن شاء الله everything is okay. إن شاء الله today we'll take revision and after that إن شاء الله we'll continue our classes إن شاء الله. First of all, we take overview about our subject and after that we taking what we are talk inshallah about our skills for this courses. After that, we are starting to know about definition of the research, and we are taking the research is systematically progress of collection and analysis information data for the purpose you are meaning, and we are taking the research is for thinking, firstly, question, second, problem, third, hypothesis, for data and analyze and discussion. And we take assignment to put on the module about what do you mean when you are listening academic research or research. And after that, we are take why, what is your research purpose? About your definition and about your research. And after that, we're taking what is meaning of a problem. The problem, you are get it or you are know it in the research, and how can we know that? And how can we put the research to solving that problem? And we are discuss more and we are explain about the problem, and we're taking the definition of the problem. We are talking some difficulties and challenges which in research when he want to explain this problem, and after that he will know about that problem by theory, by literature review, by previous studies, and after that he will put suggestion and he want to put recommendation about that problem to solving that problem, or put some solving that problem or as that applicable. And we are taking example about that problem. We are taking around 5 or 10 problems. We are getting on the linguistics, and we are taking that problem on technical or languages or the skills for the problems. And after that, we are taking some problem about the language and how can we put a problem on that on that topic. And we are taking, can you list the second assignment, can you list down for future and share them with us. And we are waiting on the model to explain about that one. And after that, we want to know about the future. And we are taking, if you want to talk about the future, must be had a three thinking when you know about the futures. And we are talking on the on that one. We have a three thinking. Firstly, readable and readable and transparent. This three is very important things when a research he want to know about the research, because he want to know the readability means allowing other researcher testing the study findings. I want to explain about this one. Something when you want to do a research must be this research is in you, because when you show some studies or previous studies, for example, we take example, if you want to talking about skills English, how can we develop the skills English on the student? For example, you see problem, as students, we have difficulties to get the skills English when you're learning. And you know this is a problem. Firstly, first of all, after you get the title, you start to research from the previous studies. Anyone he talking about the previous studies for these studies, and you want to know if you see some, for example, you want to talk about the Isra student university, and you want to know how can we develop that skills. You firstly you want to see if you see any researcher he writing about develop skills and he talking about Al Isra University, we cannot talk same thing because same topic and same area. Oh, it's okay, but cannot be do it. If you want to talking about Al Islamic University can because other area, and you can get same title but different area because we have different findings and different analysis and different discussion and different recommendation because different area. For example, you want to talk about the student in Egypt. So you see topic develop skills for English student on the Egypt University, and you want to get same title to Isra University, but you want to change that area. And we want to change the area, must be changed some Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, different research proposed and research question, and they say because the student is different, area is different, situation is different, because you want to know how can be this one. And transparency is the very, very important because you want to get the information to giving the people, must be have transparency. Because the transparency for the research, giving the people a good and better the information. Because some researcher after you, he want to take this information and he will building that future for the future. Because must be have transparency for the research papers. And that's what is very necessary for research, when he get the data, when he want to research propose, when he want to collect the data, when he want to analyze the data, when he want to discussion that data, when he put the recommendation. Because some researcher after you, he will get this recommendation and he want to build to new research because must be have transparency about it. After that, we take the follow writing about the research future, and after that must be known about this one. After that, we want to take types of research. On academic research, we have a three way for the research. First one, quantitative data. After that, qualitative data. After that, we have a mixed method data. And everyone, when you want to do the research, must be use a different way, be know about a different research. Because every way, we have a different tools to get the data. For example, quantitative research, you use questionnaire, you use a survey, but you cannot use interview because this research using for experimental design on the hypothesis and follow the quantification of data and some storing for the analysis data. This is important things for the quantitative data. Because you need the quantitative. You have a lot of data. You want to get this data and you want to analyze by numbers for using SPSS, you want to use AMOS, up to you, you want to use it for the research. Quantitative data, we are using for experimental design. And we have a Croswell. Croswell, he talking about six way you want to use it when you want to use quantitative research. It's very important when you want to get it some information from the big cases and you want to get it the data for them. This is for the quantitative data. After that, we have a qualitative data. Qualitative data you want to use for this one when you want to have, you need the qualitative data and the qualitative studies you want to use for experimental design. And for example, I give you example. For the quantitative and the qualitative, to understand. Quantitative, for example, we are taking before, we have, you want to develop the skills of the students. It's okay. I want to, because when I want to, Allahumma sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are talking about development skills, student learning for the English, for the English, for the student on the university. For example, we have on the, we have, for example, 1,000 students. You cannot interview 1,000 students. You want to use a questionnaire because you want to know what is the purpose of research and how can be the answer for the research from the student. But if you want to use same research, but you take the cases, not the student, you're taking the teacher. For example, in university, we have, for example, 10 teachers. You give interview qualitative data from the research because we have simple, small teachers and easy to get the information. Because when you want to get the interview from the teacher, sometimes you get the same information. When you get the same information from after 4, 4, 5, you get it stopped because you take what you needed from the research. After that, we talking about the quantitative data. You get it the number I talking before when you talking the when you talking about a qualitative data, you get it the numbers from the student because you have a lot of the students and you have a questionnaire, okay? And you get it the numbers from the method. And quantitative and qualitative, we have difference. We have a difference hypothesis from the studies and the methods we are different. And the research we have different, and design research we have different, area we have different, not area, no. The cases and the population for the study is different from the student. And if you want to know more about that, can you go back to the book to know about it? After that, we take what is different between the quantitative and the qualitative data. This is important things you want to know it when you want to do the research. Firstly, you want to know about the measurement. You want to know about objective. You want to know about verification. You want to know about outcome, not output, not outcome. You want to know about hypothesis for the research. This is for the quantitative. For qualitative, must be known about the control for the research and subjective for the research. And subjective, you mean in the personality for the person you want to get the information from them and the process. And you want to know about the individual cases, single cases studies. You want to know about that. That's a very important things. And the dynamic of the studies. This is very important things to know what is different between the quantitative and the qualitative research. And after that, we want to talking about a type of research is hard data and soft data. When you want to talking about the hard data and soft data, you want to talking hard data, meaning hard data meaning is some of knowledge and skills and results you want for the hard data. You want to know about the knowledge and taking from the right away from this data. And the result you are want to put it must be have a good the result you want to take it from the qualification ability of the data from the person. And so data is qualitative and is the based on opportunities for the soft data. And every time you want to using the soft data from the, because you want to take from the studies. Other things I want to giving you about the quantitative and qualitative, sorry about go back. The quantitative data, quantitative, you want to using a program SPSS, AMOS, for the analyzed data. For qualitative data, you want to use ANOVA software for the analyzed data. And we're taking hard and soft. Third of things, mixed method. Mixed method way, when you want to collect data from quantitative and qualitative, mixed method. Why sometimes you want to using mixed methods? This is important things you want to know about the research. First of all, you want to using research mix method when you want to get it, for example, questionnaire, and you want using interview. For example, we're talking about development skills of the student. You want to develop these skills. Can you use questionnaire and interview? For you want the questionnaire from the student and you get it the interview from the teacher. But all of these, you coming back and you know about that from your purpose of research, academic research. And you must you understand what do you want from that research to get it from the student and from the student or from the cases you want to use in from the research. And we have a six way to mix method use. Crosswell, he put on his book, six way, triangle way, and full way. We have six way, inshallah, we'll take it when you take the methodology from the research. And you, all the scientists from the research, you take, for example, Crosswell and Mendeleev, and after many one, he talking, the mixed method is best a way to using from the social science research, because you give it, you are combined from the quantitative and qualitative, and after that you are mixing that one to giving a good discussion and good design for the studies. This one, when you want to use the data and you want to use the research, you take first of all from the paper or thesis formatting, first page, title page. After that, we have abstract, we have introduction. The introduction, we having five thinking, introduction, or background of the studies, problem statement. We have after problem statement, we have research question, research design, hypothesis, definition of the conceptual. After this one, we have previous studies for the that study. We take literature review. This meeting with the title. After that one, we have a methodology. Methodology is a way we're using for the research. After methodology, you want to analyze or result the data. You get the result data from a way you are taking from methodology. After you get the result, you get a discussion. A discussion, you are going to discussion the result that. After that, you put the reference you are using from that study. This is linking together for the research. Our a big assignment from this one, now we are thinking what is research, what is the problem, what is the way of research, and we get it some example about research. Now we want to starting to write a title from the research and share with me to see it, to discuss about the title research, to starting about your research. And this is a big assignment, you get it from the previous thinking. And we have 10 Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. We have for the research propose, we have around 10 GPA or 10 10 درجات, 10 درجات على البحث. فأتمنى منكم طلاب الأعزاء أن تشاركوني العناوين المطلوبة للبحث. After we get this one, start to research about title of your research proposal and share with me on the model. And inshallah, we'll put something from the model about the research. And we hope to start to share with me some topic, and we hope to interaction with me or intervention with me to understanding more about the research. And next class, we take the type of curriculum of research at academic research, inshallah. And we hope to understanding what we are meaning about the research. And if you have any question, anything must be shared with me to model, and we are ready to discuss for anything. And this is my phone number. If anyone he want to contact with me by WhatsApp, this is my number. Anyone he want to contact with me can be contact about WhatsApp. And thank you for see this video. And we hope to link with me on Moodle. And the mid exam on the we are preparing for the mid exam, inshallah, will be inshallah after we are discuss our research, and after we take the type of research and the general thing for the research methodology. Thank you, jazakumullah khair. I want to summarize about what are we are talking, and after that we are finishing. احنا في خلال المحاضرات الماضية في البداية تعرفنا على المادة، بعد ذلك أخذنا تعريف البحث، بعد ذلك أخذنا المشكلة، بعد ذلك أخذنا بعض الأمثلة على الأبحاث، بعد ذلك أخذنا السمات للبحث العلمي، إنه ما يكون في تكرار، يكون شفاف، تكون قابل للتعديل و مرن. وعندك نقطة مهمة جدا، أنه يجب أن يكون العنوان المختار يوجد به مراجع، لأنه هذه نقطة مهمة جدا 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 في موضوع البحث العلمي. ثم بعد ذلك أخذنا أنواع البحث، قلنا في عنا الكمي وفي عنا الكيفي، وعملنا مقارنة بين الكمي والكيفي. ثم بعد ذلك أخذنا أنواع البحث السريع أو الهارد اللي هو البحث الساخن يعني السريع، وأخذنا السوفت اللي هو الهادئ، وهذا يتم استخدام كواليتيتيف داتا لأنه يحتاج إلى وقت ويحتاج إلى جهد ويحتاج إلى بيانات. ثم بعد ذلك أخذنا الميكس ميثود، الطريقة اللي هي التي تربط بين الكوانتيتيف والكواليتيتيف، الكمي والكيفي، وقلنا أن هناك بعض الطرق إن شاء الله سنأخذها في المستقبل. ثم بعد ذلك أخذنا إيش هي العناصر الأساسية للبحث للبروبوزل، وأعطيتكم رقم جوالي لو أي واحد يحتاج التواصل معي عبر الواتساب ممكن أن يتواصل. في النهاية أشكركم على الحضور. Thank you our student, and we hope inshallah to understand what I mean. If you have any question, share with me on the midterm on the Moodle, sorry. And jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.